While bulk importing the data in your listing site, you may have faced this error or similar error like this. In this video, we will see what is the correct way to bulk import data in Geodirectory and without facing any issues like this. First thing, make sure to create all those categories that you need in your listing. So I have created all the category that I may need in my listing data. And then go to the settings and create all those fields that you need. For example, in my CSV file or in my data file, I don't have Facebook field, so I will remove it. Similarly, I will do it for other fields. I will remove all the unwanted field and add all those required fields that are there in my CSV file also. So I will keep checking all the fields that are there in my CSV file, and if there is any field that is not created, I will create it here. And it is most needed for you to create or define all those fields before proceeding with the import. Otherwise, you will import the CSV file and then there will be some fields which will not have data, and then you will have to re-import it again and again. So instead, define it before import, before starting with the import process. Now the next step is to create a sample CSV file. For that, you can click on add new and fill up all the fields that are there, because we have already defined all the required fields in our custom field section. So you can just fill up this entire form and click on publish button. So now our post is ready here. Now let's go and export the CSV file. For that, go in the settings, Geodirectory settings, and then import export. And here you can select the custom post type and click on export. So here I have my sample CSV file exported, and I have imported it in Google Sheets, so to better show you guys. And there are few things that you should know about this CSV file, this sample CSV file. The one is ID. So as you can see, since this post exists in my WordPress, it have an ID, but you cannot define a ID for a post. So skip this field when you are adding a new listing. You can skip it or make it, keep it empty. Post title will be the post title, post content will be the content of your listing post. Status, by default, any listing that is published in WordPress, as you know, it have a status published, so we can keep it published. And post author, by default the post author is one, that means it is admin. But if you have, you know, want to assign it to any other user, you can put their user ID there. Post type is basically post type of your CPT, so you can basically find it here. So this is my post type, businesses, you can find it here in the URL, post type equal to GD places. This post date and post modified date are WordPress generated, so you cannot modify them, or you should not modify them. But if you want to modify, you can, no problem with it. But I will say, if you are importing a new post, you can keep it empty. GD post tags. Post tags, you can pass a comma separated string to add multiple tags to a post. Post categories. So as you can see, it's 3, 9. That means it's the ID of your post category. So if any of your, if you are importing a new listing and you want to add it in a specific category, go in the backend, click here in post category section. So here basically you can find the category IDs listed, so you can keep add a post in multiple categories with comma separated IDs. Default category is among these two or multiple category, which will be the default, you can set it. Otherwise the first entry of this comma separated string will be considered as default category. Featured, if you want to keep your listing featured or not. So there is street two. Basically you should now be sure that this address should be identified by Google Map. Otherwise your listing will your listing will get imported, but then it will have map related issue. So make sure that this address is valid, and city name, region, country name should be valid, not anything you are typing here, not like that. Zip code is again valid. So latitude and longitude, you don't need to worry about it if you are using Google Geocoding API key in your setting. So basically, so here in the map setting, if you are adding the geocoding API key and Google Map API key, then you don't need to worry about adding latitude and longitude for your every new listing. Google will automatically identify the latitude and longitude by address that you have given here. So, but in some cases, if you're not using the geocoding API, then you will have to manually enter those latitude and longitude. Email address is basically email address. It should be in a valid format, as I said. Website, then you have the phone number, then you have we have the LinkedIn ID, which is a URL, and then we have this post image. So this is quite confusing for a few of GE customers, where they feel it hard to edit this field. So this field, basically GD has well explained in their doc. So here you can see, so this double dot is basically considered as a separator. Here you can understand it better. So there will be URL, and there is a line, and then ID line, then title line, then description, and then there are two double dots, and then the same thing repeated. So this is basically one entry, then second image entry, then third image entry. Here you can see basically you have the colon, then you have image URL, then you have three dot line, and then another image URL, then three line, then another image URL. So same we are seeing here. You have the image URL, and then you have ID, and then you have the another line where you can type the title, and then description here, and then double dots, and then same thing repeated for another image, URL, ID, title, description. But in some cases, you do for new image specifically, you don't have the ID. In that case, you can basically keep the URL, and then three dots, and then colon. Let's set an entry and check how we can do this thing. So for new listing, as I said, I'm importing a new listing. I will skip this field. I will add it as sample listing, maybe something like that, and then we have some text for sample listing. The default status is publish, author is one, or let's change this. Instead of one, do we have any user? Let's create one. Yeah, then ID, as you can see, the ID is two for this user. So I will add this ID, use this ID here too, and entry will be in GD places. Skip this field. A tag will be sample listing. Category will be videos. So for example, or maybe videos, videos, anything for now. Just tell me videos, comma. There'll be festivals 7. Okay. Now default category among them will be, let's skip it for now. You can make it, or I will just show a demo of how, you know, how it will automatically pick 8. Feature, no feature. And then address. So let's add Chandra Bihar. New Delhi, for example. Reason is Delhi, India. We don't need this. Email ID will be sample gd@gmail.com. https sample.com. Let's skip this. LinkedIn will, we don't need it. So for post images, you can put any image URL that is publicly accessible. For example, I'm just using this image from this blog. Let's open this image here and copy this URL. Yeah, so basically here you have to keep in mind that your URL should end with the you know, image link. You can skip this line because I have seen that many of the customers face this issue when they have sub parameter behind their image extension. So I will just add it, and then since I don't have any ID, let's skip the ID. I don't have any title, I don't have any description, let's skip it. And then we need double dot if we want to add another image. Yeah, so here I will copy the URL of this image. Let's add it and then dash, and this time I have the ID of this post, so I will add the ID and then dash, and I don't have any title or description. Let's skip it for now. Okay, so this is the format for the post images. Let's save it and check with after importing it. Okay, now go back to the GD site and click on Geodirectory settings, and here in the import export, and let's import the new listing file. And here basically you have two options, whether you want to update if post IDs already exist, or you want to ignore the listing if post ID already. So we, since we haven't changed anything in our existing post, let's ignore it for now and let's import it. So here basically you can see that failed to retrieve the GPS info from OpenStreet nominative server. And why this is, and as you can see in the business section also, your post is not imported yet. So this is basically because, as I said, we have kept our latitude longitude field empty for our post, and we are not using geocoding API yet. So if I go here in this journal setting, you can see I am not using geocoding API. I'm using OpenStreetMap. So with OpenStreetMap, the code having hard time to find latitude longitude for based on the address. So in this case, now I will add my map API key. And now I have added my map API key, and I'm gonna select Google Map here. Let's save it. So now let's import once again. As you can see, one is ignored due to already exist, and one from the two is edit. So let's see if our post got edited or not. So here you can see that the new listing has arrived here, and if I go and edit and check this thing here, basically we have all the data, and also you can see that this latitude longitude got created automatically when we have added our geocoding API and Google Map API keys. Thank you so much guys for watching these videos. If you like these videos and found it helpful, please hit the like button and do comment in the comment section if you have any queries. I will surely answer them. And you can subscribe and hit the bell icon for updates related to my upcoming videos, because I'm gonna put many more videos for GD customers in future videos of this channel. So stay tuned and have a great day.